going on, everybody, and welcome back to Movie Files. Here with a new movie review, and this time it's for the new Netflix original film, Paddleton, starring Ray Romano and Mark Duplass. Now, before I get into my review, I want to thank you first and foremost for clicking on this video, and also welcome to our channel. If you haven't already, definitely do us a favor and do yourself a favor and subscribe to our channel, and make sure you hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date with all of our movie reviews, trailer reactions, TV reviews, unboxing videos, and giveaways. So definitely subscribe to our channel. Now, if this is your first time watching our reviews here on Movie Files, I just keep it very simple. I talk about the positives, the negatives, give you guys my thoughts on the film. Since it's on Netflix, I give you my opinion if it's worth streaming, and also we don't do spoilers, so this is a spoiler-free review. So with that out of the way, let's talk about Paddleton. After he's diagnosed with terminal cancer, middle-aged Michael asks his neighbor friend Andy to help him in his life before the disease does. Alright, so as the synopsis reads, you have Andy and Michael, two neighbors, two friends, and one of the characters, Michael, is going through a really rough time. As the synopsis reads, he's going through a terminal cancer, which automatically, at least for me, I have a personal connection with someone, losing someone with cancer. And so automatically, it piqued my interest. And then once I saw the trailer and I saw who was in it, I was definitely interested in this movie. And kind of going off of the positives there, Ray Romano and Mark Duplass, this movie hinges on their performance, and there's nothing short of just a great performance by these two actors. I'm one of those people that always believe these comedians always have, I don't want to say dark side, but always have that level of range where they can give you the funnies. Obviously, Ray Romano, Mark Duplass, they have a long history of being in comedic movies and TV shows, obviously, but these actors that have those comedic moments always tend to have that extra layer to them. In this movie, Mark and Ray's chemistry on this film is great, and the dramatic moments are really great between these two. From the very opening scene, you can just see the chemistry. You can get the tone, which I love about a film like this, is you know what they're going for. Again, I think a lot of the, if I'm not mistaken, some of the websites label it as a comedy, which it is a comedy, but it's definitely, I would say, more of a drama mixed in with comedy. And I love, from the opening scene, it kind of lets you know where their friendship is, how this movie's going to be, and I kind of really appreciate that. And it definitely has vibes of, like, it's a lot of movies that deal with cancer and deal with the, you know, the brings in some comedy to the obviously this tragedy that a lot of us suffer with family members and friends, things of that nature. But this movie really reminded me of 50-50 in a sense that it obviously touches on the dramatic elements and what someone goes through, and not just the person that's obviously suffering the illness and the disease, but also the people that's surrounded by them. And this movie does a great job of this, and I really enjoy the chemistry of these two. And also too, this movie is definitely, it's an hour and a half, but it's a slow burn as well. But I just love that the moments in this movie, there's moments where they just let the scene breathe, and they let you sit in a room with the character, and just as you could just see them kind of calculating their thoughts and their feelings and emotions. And I really appreciate that about the film. Mark Duplass helped the director write this film. You could definitely see that this is probably a personal story for everyone involved. And again, I just really, I think this is something we can all relate to. If it's not cancer, we've all, you know, I would assume we all have dealt with losses in our life. And I think this film really does depicts the both sides of the element. Again, like I said, it's nothing, you can never be in the position if of the person that's dying of cancer or any terminal illness. But, you know, we can all relate to the person of how we perceive, you know, how we're seeing what this person is going through. And I think that this film captures that beautifully, where we're watching Ray Romano, and there's a scene, a really good scene, where they kind of express that, you know. Obviously, Mark is going through this, and he's the dying man, as he says in the scene, and Ray says, well, I'm the other guy, and we could all relate to that. So I really, this film really resonated with me, and I think that this film is something that I would recommend you guys to watch. You know, there's really not a lot of negatives that I can give for this review, other than, again, it's advertised as a comedy, and it definitely has some comedic moments, but definitely don't go into this film looking to be a gut punch laugh. It has organic laughs, but it's definitely more of a drama, and again, I think these two actors do a great job of delivering the scenes and doing a great job just in general. So I'm giving this film a 4 out of 5. Definitely recommend it on Netflix. I will say, as far as, again, setting expectations, this is a good comedy movie with comedy moments, but it's not a comedy with drama. It's a drama with comedy. So definitely keep that in mind while you're watching it. Let me know what you guys think of the film once you check it out over the weekend, or if it's, you know, you're watching this review months later, if you eventually come around to seeing it, let me know what you guys thought of it. As always, like this video, share this video. As I said up top, subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We will be giving a giveaway for a movie pretty soon, so keep an eye out for that. If you're not already following us on our social medias, make sure you're doing so. It's in the description below. Follow us on Instagram. We're at Movie Files. We're on Twitter at Movie Files Live. We have a Facebook page simply called Movie Files, and we're also on Stardust as well. So definitely follow us. Again, thank you for watching this review. Keep an eye out for more coming down the line. Thank you for watching this video, and we'll see you in the next one.